Finally, as Star Trek's Mr. Spock might say, it's only logical.
Some Buffalo school kids are learning lessons in logic right here on Earth, and Mike Randall joined them today.
There are a million stories in this mini city. Well, actually, there are only 120. That's how many kids it took to construct Logic Town at Buffalo's Olmsted 67.
Mm-hmm. I like that. That's great.
After 25 years of teaching, Diane Panashevitz has devised a new way of teaching a subject she values as much as the three R's, logic.
Those days of kids sitting at their desk and writing workbooks all day is gone. Children want to have hands-on activities, so the kids built this town to provide that sort of thing.
The youngsters have taken this beyond the typical classroom project and have used it as a springboard to learn about planning, map making, and problem solving.
It took a lot of thinking to make this, and it took quite a bit of work because we had to do a lot of spray painting. We had to think of what kind of colors we wanted.
And all the streets are something to do with logic, like, for example, Relationship Road and Sequence Street.
It helped us to think more logically.
Thinking logically would be to think that you are not going to win the lotto.
It's mostly problem-free, and sometimes it has problems when too big of people walk into it.
I thought that would be half the fun.
When you walk through here, it's like being in the middle of a Godzilla movie.
Oops. Sorry, pal.
Sure, Logic Town has been a brain-bending, mind-expanding experience, but I think it was fun, too. It's only logical. In Buffalo, Mike Randall, Eyewitness News.
Ooh, what smart kids.
Yeah, that's why I was always a mediocre student. It never seemed logical to me.
And you never learned how to do spray paint, either. Thanks for joining us.